That's a lot of fish.
What's up, everyone? My name is Brett, and sometimes I wear a beret, and today we are once again talking about a rather fishy blaster, but don't let that concern you, because... Anyhow, today we're talking about the Dualfish. This is a dual-stage worker swordfish. This was created by my good friend Kyle. We basically got in the hobby together, and while I'm off running silly loadouts, doing dumb things, he's here creating powerhouses and running them super effectively. It's exactly what it sounds like. I mean, two stages, does 235 with AccuFakes. It's really good. It's darn good. It's fishy good. Copyright. I obviously have a lot of gameplay footage with me running low-powered stuff. Most of the games that I play in are super stock, 150 or so. And this one is good for that next level of gameplay. It's a lot of fun to use, and this thing screams. Let's talk about how it looks. These are a signature of Kyle's modding. Yes, these are Vortex discs. I imagine this would be a good use of the knockoff ones that don't fly as well, but he does use these to cover his motors. That's just something that he always did, so you either like that or hate that, but I like it. It's very familiar to me. Here's what it looks like on this side. I mean, there's a lot of wiring inside right now that it's hard to show on camera, so we already recorded a little in-depth look that you can take a look at now to explain some more.
All right, and here's how you make a dual fish. It's basically wired up the same way as you would wire a strife with a MOSFET. Well, two MOSFETs, actually. We got two MOSFETs in parallel right here, and they're both heat-synced. One here, the other one I heat-synced on the other side. Both of that is connected to our dual-stage riot cage. This is a 41.5 millimeter cage for both stages. Both of these right now are running Worker High Crush white ABS wheels. And the motors are 180 motors, just generic Chinese 180 motors, but you can use whatever motor you feel like. These should be spinning at around 45K RPM, so pretty darn fast. Look for like eclipse speeds. All this goop around here is just for extra silencing, because at two stages, that's going to matter. These right here are diodes for your motors. This makes sure that your MOSFETs stay nice and happy, so you don't explode your MOSFETs, basically. I just solder them right across the motors, although a lot of people will solder them across the MOSFETs. And of course, we're just using the standard mount for a sub-mini micro switch. The cuts that you have to do to this blaster are, first of all, you have to cut your front muzzle piece like this. We're utilizing every single bit of space in this shell. So we're just about right up to the limit for this dual stage cage. On each half of this, you have to cut right here. Of course, I have cuts for 180s, but you have to cut straight across this line. You can also see it here. You'll have to do some shaving around here as well. But hopefully this gives you a general idea of what you need to cut. Of course, you need to cut all these ribs, of course, as well. And some of the cage ridges to make sure that your cage fits as well. Right here as well. Other than that, it's pretty simple. Also, you should be able to fit an auto kit in here if you want to. Right now, my battery requirements aren't good enough for an auto kit, or my battery isn't good enough for running an auto kit, but you still have these mounts here so you can put in your gearbox. Just like that. I don't have the Worker Swordfish auto kit. Worker, please sponsor me. So if you want 220 FPS at, I don't know, 12 darts a second, sure, you can do that. I just hope your battery is good enough. So last bonus tip for modding any swordfish is to reset your spring. Usually it's on this post. But if you reset it to this post, and you cut this out, and cut all this plastic out, you will get a much nicer trigger pull. And of course, remember to lubricate your triggers.
All right, cyclone wheels. Worker black wheels. Worker white wheels. And finally, worker red metal wheels. And yes, of course, it does run on a 3S LiPo. This 2200 milliamp hour battery is gonna deliver exactly what you want. It fits in just barely inside of this extended battery tray, and that's a testament to the blaster itself. And there is a hole that Kyle drilled out right here and right here that actually allows the battery extensions and connections to come out and connect because space. So obviously this is not going to be the prettiest blaster you've ever seen. I'm not going to, you know, sugarcoat that. It's not super, super beautiful when you see chunks of your blaster taken out, but it's still completely useful and you can still put on your Chris Vector kit if you so desired. So let's take a look at that first gameplay footage I had with the Dualfish. Again, different kind of game for me. Brand new blaster in my hands, didn't know what to totally expect. It was amusing. Take a look.
Take up an offensive position. Hey Kyle, this works pretty well.
Yeah. Only before now, ammo.
All right, move in, Green, move in!
Only three lives.
All right, Goose is right in front of us. Where's the drop point?
Where's the drop point?
I didn't. Where?
There.
Get him before he gets it.
There he is.
Green wins.
Goose. Good game, guys.
And that's how you deliver a golden goose. So this blaster, it's freaking fun to use, and it's also freaking loud. I won't lie about that one. That's why I turn the volume down sometimes when firing it. What can I say? I plan to use this more for games where I can actually, you know, get closer to that 250 FPS cap. Most notably, Ion Rush style, ADL style games coming up in the future. The accuracy on it is pretty reliable, I've got to say. Kyle was surprised when he started testing them too. Kyle's also got some gameplay footage with his own when he started testing them out. And if you are really interested in this kind of blaster, you can actually contract him to make one for you. I'll include a link down in the description below to his Reddit and Discord usernames. He goes by CaolDubh there. So if you would like to commission him to make you a Dualfish, you can reach out to him and he will quote you a price. He also does a lot of just general strife rewires, so strife Evader, most of those style blasters. Obviously, he's a friend, but if you trust me, he's a pretty talented modder. Everyone in the Bay Area is well familiar with him and how hard he plays and how hard he uses his blasters, so this one's still kicking. I think yours will be too. But again, if you want to make your own, I say go for it. So that's the Dualfish. It's my primary of choice for the Foam Pro Tour, and hopefully it won't fail me now, won't fail me then. Yeah, I like it. Thank you everyone for watching, and I'll see you later.